Hello ladies and gentlemen, welcome to this channel again, Java Revisited. My name is V and I'm going to show you the top courses that I know to learn JavaScript and master it in a short amount of time. JavaScript is not difficult, but it's going to take time just with any programming language to be able to master the fundamentals and move up the ranks. So let's get going, stay tuned, and let's go and start the ride. Hello ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the first review that I'm going to cover you. It's the Complete JavaScript Course 2022 from Zero to Expert. Now if you look at this course, it's a bestseller course. This is one of the most recommended courses. I would say it's probably the best on Udemy for learning JavaScript for beginners. The course has an average rating of 4.8, so you can clearly see that this is a very attractive course on Udemy, and it's clearly a bestseller. Now, the course is created by Jonas Schmidtman, and if you look at the outline just beneath, you will see that there's a whole range of topics covered. Now, this is really going to get you pretty employable. You can see that there's the advanced topics covered. Things like OOP is also covered, which is very advanced topics, classes, constructors, encapsulation. You can also see to the right, there's the ES6, which is the later version of JavaScript, coupled with these libraries. And then you can see there's a whole lot of architecture and also some of the calls like Ajax and APIs, which is also going to augment your understanding of this language. Now, if you scroll a bit down, you can see the course includes 69 hours on-demand video, 18 downloadable resources, you get a certificate of completion, you get 22 articles and access on both mobile and TV. And if you scroll down, you can look at the whole course outline, and you can see that it starts with JavaScript fundamentals, so it will teach you all the stuff about variables, some basic things like the types, classes, and then you will go and navigate through to HTML and CSS, which is your styling languages, and you will go to DOM and event fundamentals, which means you will go and play with the idea of the DOM, the headings, the pro headings, and you will learn how to manipulate it by code. Then you will go into data structures and strings, and then you're going to progress from there in the more advanced stuff. If you scroll down, you can see that the requirements requires no coding experience, so you don't have to have any coding experience before embarking on this course. You can view it on any computer platform, Windows, Mac, OS, or Linux. And you also get a basic understanding of HTML and CSS, as you can see with the course outline. Now, if you scroll even further down, you can look at the reviews, and you can see how well worded these reviews are. And if you scroll even further down to the bottom, you can see there's some information about your instructors. Okay, so next up is the JavaScript, the Complete Guide 2022 Beginner to Advanced. It covers everything from the very beginning all the way up to your JS expert level. You can look at the aggregate course rating, which is 4.6, very, very high. The course creator is Maximilian Schwarzmuller. And if you scroll down a little bit, you will see what you will learn is the very basic stuff to the left top. You will cover things like variables, functions, objects, and arrays. That's what you're going to start off with. Then you're going to deep dive into things like prototypes, JavaScript engines, and how it works behind the scenes. So that's going to be your compiler, your pre-compiler, and the speed of it, and how to maximize that. So that's also pretty intermediate stuff that you're going to start doing with. And then you're going to do your event handling, asynchronous coding, and HTTP requests. That's your parallel stuff. So that's going to be very industrious if you can do this very well. Then, of course, you're going to cover testing, security, and deployment. That's going to be your debugging. So 90% of what you're going to do in a coding bootcamp or in a coding in a job environment, you're going to be debugging your code, right? You're going to find that your code is going to need a lot of restructuring and tinkering, and that's your debugging stuff. And to the right, you can see the OOP, the object-oriented programming. As with the last course, you're going to cover this. This is your classes and your instances and your heritability. So that's what you're going to do to simplify your programs, right? And then you're going to structure the DOM. The DOM is cool because it's literally the meat of your JavaScript. So DOM is document object modeling. And this is where you're going to talk with a hierarchy of your web page, right? So it's like a button that you click and something's going to pop up and, you know, a heading might disappear or appear or something else might merge. That's integrating your DOM. And then you're going to go into the memory leak busting, memory performance, and metaprogramming, right? So that's going to go into the memory stuff, which is very advanced topics. So it truly covers a lot of stuff. Now, if you scroll a bit down, you can see it's 52 hours on demand video. You can download all the videos in the content section. You get 77 articles. You get access on mobile and TV. You get assignments, and it's pretty cool about this course, is that you get assignments just like with university. You can complete assignments and you can compare, and you're going to be graded on it, right? Most likely. And then you get certificate of completion with the course. And if you scroll down even further, you can look at the course content. It's pretty packed and concise. And then if you go even further down, you can look at all the variables and all the 26 sections, I believe, is being covered here. And then if you go down, you can see the ratings. And of course, you can look at the instructor information if you go furthest down. So our next course would be the Modern JavaScript ES6 Basics, and the course rating is 4.4. It has over 16,465 students currently enrolled. If you look to the right, you'll see some features and information on ES6. Now, ES6 is the framework for JavaScript. It's the later framework and was developed in 2015 with special features like the let and the const keyword, including new libraries as well as new modules. If you want to know more information, you can actually check and Google it, exactly the features of ES6 and what it comprises of. If you look a bit to the bottom, you'll see there's 2 hours of content. The content goes into intermediate content, including advanced content, and there's also split screen video. The language is English. You don't need to download anything, and it's desktop only. If you go a bit to the bottom, you'll see learn step-by-step method. You'll see there's about 7 tasks. It's starting from the let and const keyword information. It goes into the destructoring, strings and interpolation, arrows functions, and the this keyword, which is very important with arrows, including pointers. So you get the address stuff as well. If you scroll even further down, you'll see some information on the instructor, Stanimirovleva, and you can also see information on the course rating. Hello guys, so next up is the following course is the Complete Guide to Modern JavaScript. The course comprises of 60 lessons, 24 quizzes, 15 challenges, 239 playgrounds, 2 illustrations, right? So if you look up to the right, you can see there's some information on the course here on Educative. I think that's what the platform is called. And you see that you get 7 days free access to the courses. So you can, it seems like an enrollment option that you can take with this, which means you can also do other courses in the meantime, right? So you can cancel at any time. And you can also buy this course, so you can pay it off, I think, in a year's time. Now, if you go a bit, you scroll a bit down, you can look at the takeaway skills. So the takeaway skills covers 3 takeaway skills. That's, you can learn JavaScript. You also learn a bit about TypeScript, and then you get the latest up-to-date versions of JavaScript. So this course is mainly text-based. It covers a lot of web applications and how to launch your JavaScript practice online. This is good because it's going to cut a lot of the stuff away that you would otherwise do in a normal desktop IDE. So it seems like there's a big online component with this course, which is fairly attractive to someone who's starting out and who wants to just get the gist of it and who also want to learn the meat of the language, right? So if you want to scroll a bit more down, you can look at some extra features on what you will learn, including the hands-on coding environments. Now, for you guys who want to really get started heavy on JavaScript, this is it, because you're going to get environment assignments that you can showcase to potential employers while you're busy coding, which is very attractive to an employer to see your initiative, right? You also get faster videos. So it seems like there's 2 speeds that you can pick from here. So you can get the medium and the high speed. Then there's no setup required. That's something I mentioned. You don't have to worry about fiddling with IDEs or SDKs. You can just go head on into the web page and start coding. And then the progress can be shown. So let's say how far you are, you can see and track your progress. Now the course contents has a very fairly basic course content it covers, and then it goes into JavaScript variables, data types, and functions. And it seems like there's a fair amount of quizzes that you cover as well. So it tests your understanding, so this is very good. If you scroll even further down, you can see information that this course covers ES 2016 to 2022, which means you get the up-to-date ES6 versions, which is also very promising, seeing that you get up-to-date versions of the ES now instead of just an old ES version. So you can see the whole ES section here. Now let's scroll a bit further down. So if you scroll further down, you can look at the companies that are recommending this type of courses, including Google, Amazon, Apple, Facebook, and Netflix. And then if you go even further down, you can look at the course creators and also the ratings. Now guys, now for our last course, we have the Udemy course, JavaScript Understanding the Weird Parts. And that's a course that has an average rating of 4.7. And it has over 45,000 ratings currently, and there's over 176,000 students. And also it's created by Anthony Alicea, right? So if you look to the right, you can look at the price, you can look at the options from Udemy, and you can also look at the basic course outline. So if you look at what you will learn, you will start with the fundamentals. So you will go into things like variables, and then you will progress all the way up to writing solid code. You will create a portfolio. So it also goes into inheritance, like classes and inheritance and child and parent classes. So this is good if you want to start, you know, coding right away. So it seems to jump from basics to that, which means you will have a very, very steep learning curve. And you also get to cover a lot of the important stuff. Then you go into the common pitfalls. You learn how to build your own JavaScript framework library. So you learn to dabble with that as well, and then you're going to go in learning about debugging. This is a very important topic in any programming language, is your debugging. If you don't know how to debug, you'll never be able to do a programming role in any industry. So this is really good that it covers this. And then you'll go into understanding popular JavaScript frameworks, right? So let's go a bit further down. You see the course includes 12 hours on demand video, 50 downloadable resources. You get 9 articles, access on most mobile and TV, and you get a certificate of completion. And then you can look at the companies recommending it, NASDAQ, WordPress, Box, NetApp, and Eventbrite. And then you can go down further to the course content, and you can look at the content, and it covers all that goodies that you saw at the top, and including TypeScript at the end, ES6 and transpiled languages. So you get a couple bonus sections, it seems like that. And then if you go further down, you can look at the course creator and the good ratings that this course has gotten.